successfully performing Torn at the MTV studios. I've got another question for you now.
Okay.
Now, you've had a lot of fame and a lot of success since you were really young, but tons in the last sort of year and a half.
Yes.
Does it bring you happiness or has it brought you problems?
It brings mostly happiness, yeah. I mean, I think, excuse me, the only stressful part is you're very busy. So, you know, that's the only problem, though. I mean, you get to travel and it's all good.
Now, has anybody got a question for Natalie? Who have I got down here? Simon from Surrey?
Yeah.
Simon? Hello.
Hi, Simon.
Hi, Natalie. What's the best thing about fame and what's the worst?
I think the best thing is, well, I love singing. I love music. So to be able to do that and earn a living out of it is amazing. The worst thing is probably not having enough free time and just having sometimes your personal life splurted all over the papers. That's probably the worst part of it.
Next one is from Barbara from Canada.
Hi, Barbara.
Hi. What do people get wrong about you?
What do people get wrong about me?
That's a good question.
Yeah, it is a good question. I think a lot of people expect that when they're going to meet me that I'm going to be this really miserable sod. And because my songs, well, my songs are quite sad and, you know, people are like, gosh, you're quite chirpy considering. So that's, yeah, I think people expect that if you can access that and write songs like that, that you get around morbidly or you've had some tortured past, and I haven't really.
David from Surrey. David.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you get nervous performing in front of a large crowd?
Yes, I do. I get really moody. I get quite, like, if anybody does anything out of place, I'm like, rah! I get really stressed out. And when it's like a festival or there's like a massive audience, I get this, especially like when I did Party in the Park as well, because it was like London and I hadn't really done any gigs here. I was just sick to the stomach. And then I go on stage and it's just yeah, you just let it all out. I think it's the anticipation, because they'll be like, oh, it's delayed for 20 minutes and you're like pacing. And then you just kind of want to get all this energy out. And then when you finally go out there, it's just the best feeling. And then everyone's smiling and singing along and it's great.
Do you ever forget your lyrics? Watch the audience, I'll be able to tell you.
That's happened to me before.
Has it really?
It happened in Belgium. I was singing along and I think it was City, and completely forgot the words. But for some reason, instead of like getting nervous and crying, I was actually found it quite funny, and I was going, and so I thought, I was thinking to myself, this is going on for a really long time, when am I going to remember? And then kicked in the chorus, but they kept smiling, and I don't think anyone really noticed, actually.
Just hum along. Hum along to yourself. So another one from Grania.
Is it fun making videos, and what's your favourite video that you've done, and why?
Video making is really fun, especially because probably I started in acting, so it's my chance to do a little bit of acting. My favourite video is the Torn video, by far, because it was the most fun to make.
It's a great video.
Simple.
That's my favourite. Time for another one of your tracks. Okay. Now, this one's Frightened Child.
Mm-hmm.
Now, that was a B-side, wasn't
yes.
it? And I know you particularly like this track, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
And now, do you feel when you put something on a B-side that you're kind of maybe throwing it away a little bit because it's not going to be a single?
No. I think B-sides are really, really important. Just as important as any track on the album. And any artist that I've been really into, I'm just as keen to hear the B-sides. Probably more so to hear the B-sides.
Mm.
So I think it's not like a throwaway track, you know. And this is cute because it's like, it's not a normal structure and it's quite a short song and it's just, it's really sweet.
Okay, well here it is, Frightened Child.